Y'all don't mind. Let's go back to a time when we really used to have church. We used to have a good time, praising the Lord, the Spirit and in truth.
I love them old church.
That old brother, pick up that old hymn book and
singing.
You knew exactly what he was gonna say. Sisters got happy.
I love them old church.
Folks start patting their feet, clapping their hands, and
singing.
All of a sudden, he break off in a song, something like this.
I was watching, and I won't be wrong, I get on my horse and be in our constraints, and that's all right. That's good. Amen.
Amen.
You help me, we won't be long.
Amen.
Amen. All right, amen. So, but I was watching a movie, and I guess these movies are becoming very popular. I'm always watching things from a different lens. And Anthony, there were human beings on the movie that looked like they were human, but they were actually dead. But they were moving, and they were conversing, and they had thoughts, and they just wandered around. And they were called, I don't know, something like the Awakenings. They had some name, but they were mounted zombies. And the zombies were dead, but they were somehow still alive. And they were just going around biting people. I couldn't understand the plot. Just going around, just that's all they live for. And just, but they're dead. But I kept saying that they're alive. But does that make sense?
Yeah.
They're dead, but they're alive. And as I watched that movie, I started to think, well, maybe they don't know that they're dead. Maybe because they're able to see and they're able to have intercourse with life and society as they did, perhaps because they are even able to get a reaction from those that are alive a different way, that they have a form of life that have not self-actualized, that they're actually dead.
Well,
while they're living. And I begin to think about the fall of mankind. How that God said to mankind in the very beginning that the day that you eat of that tree, you shall surely die.
Man.
But it doesn't appear that men recognize that they are in a state of death. Mm-hmm. Perhaps because they can go to work, they can eat, they can talk, they can reproduce, that man has forgotten all about God's remnant, his verb, in Genesis chapter 3, and verse number 1, where he describes the work of the enemy. And then he says to them, that moves about verse 3 or 4, he says to the woman, he says to mankind, of all the trees that I have created, you may eat of, but of this one particular tree you shall not eat of. But of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, you shall not, and this is Satan talking, eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. Verse 4, the Bible says, and the serpent said unto the woman, you shall not surely die. Verse 5, we watch the continuing digression from God's word. God knoweth, God do know, that in the day you eat thereof, your eyes shall be opened. You shall be as little g gods, knowing good and evil. Verse 6, Bible says, and when the woman saw the tree was good. Now I want you to underscore mankind's perception. I want you to underscore that God said that the tree was not to be eaten from, but when the woman saw, it was not the discussion with the serpent, but it was her own perception. And she saw that the tree was what? Good for food. And that it was what? Pleasant to the eyes. The misconception is that somehow the devil taught the woman into eating of the tree. We argue by him changing one word. But the Bible says when she saw, when she came into her own perception, saw that the tree was good to eat, how you see it, because it was pleasant to what? To her eyes. And the tree to be desired made one wise, she took the fruit thereof. Now the Bible says that all that is in the world is the lust of the flesh, the lust
of the eye,
and the pride of life.
Man.
Stay with me now.
Man.
She challenged her own perception of what life could be and would be. She challenged the great God, the creator of everything, the omnipotent, the omnipresent God, and by her own thought process, decreed and decided within herself that the tree was not a bad thing to do. But she decided she would not die. Mm. Now life came from God.
Amen.
And when she ate the ate of the tree, she gave that to her husband, and he ate also. Now stay with me, because to the text we go in Romans chapter 7, verse number 9, you'll see again the thought concept or the perception of mankind toward what God is saying. The Bible says in verse number 9, "For I was alive without the law." What was the law? The law was of every tree you can eat of, but of one particular tree. The law was the law of Moses. The law of Moses pointed out that when a man sinned, that there were consequences. What was the law? The law is found in Romans chapter 3. For the wages of sin is what?
Death.
Death. Now Paul says, I was alive once. What do you mean I was alive once? There was a time when man had no perception of sin. There was a moment in space and time where everything was innocent, where everything was good, because God said it was good.
Man.
We were alive.
Yes,
but
sir.
When man saw that the tree was good,
good
yes, according to him, when man saw with the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye and the pride of life, he rose up against God.
Man.
And God says, by law, now watch this, by law, because Paul says, for I once was alive without the law, once, but when the commandment came, sin did what?
It revived.
Revived, and what happened to me?
I died.
I died. But the problem is, although we died, we were alive. We were walking around dead zombies, alienated from Christ.
Yes, sir.
I'm about to get to my good boy. God said you would die, but it didn't look like we
died.
We died because we were still
walking
alive, and we still could think, and we still could reason, and we still could have ideology and our own idiocracies and our own idiosyncrasies that we could have. And because we became isocratic and so lost in ourselves and in what we wanted to do, we forgot that we were dead in that very moment.
Man.
I stop by to tell you that the moment you turn your back on God, you, although you are alive, you are
dead.
And you can never get that moment back again. What moment can they get back again? That mankind has never, let me say it again, mankind has never been able to undo what was done in that moment of time.
Man.
In that very moment, Adam will never forget what it was like before the fall of man and what life has been like after the fall of man. Sin and you cannot live together. If sin lives, you
die.
And if you die, Christ lives. I'm crucified with Christ. Nevertheless,
I live.
I die daily. Why? So Christ can live. But sin and men can't live. So if you are in sin, although you can think and you can reason, you are not living, you are dying because sin and you can't live together.
Man.
Y'all with me so far?
Yes, sir.
What does sin kill? What does the death look like? Well, according to the scriptures, I am dead when I am what? In sin. I find that the scriptures are right there. I'm so dead to what? I'm not dead. My heart is beating. My brain is functioning. person, but I'm dead. Dead to what? What did God mean in the garden? He said, you'll be dead the day you eat of this tree.
Separated from
they
God.
Became dead to everything spiritual that God put there for me.
Man.
The songs no longer had any meaning in them. God's word. You ever heard a preacher say, I'm preaching to a dead church? They're alive. Oh, they sitting in the pew. Their eyes are blinking.
Well.
Yeah. The chest is moving up and down.
Yes, sir.
But somebody's dead.
Yes,
to the word
of God.
Of God.
Man.
God is saying that the day you die, you will become irresponsive to me. Now, I don't know about you, but there's a lot of things I want to be, but I don't ever want to be separated from God.
Man.
I don't ever want to be distanced from God. I want to be alive. The Bible says in Acts 14, around verse 22, it is in him we move and breathe and have our very own being.
Well.
And the problem is that we are trying to recover constantly from the fall of man in the garden. We are striving, we're working hard and diligently trying to reach men, but we forget that these men are not alive, they're dead. Dead folk can't respond to God's word.
Man.
Dead folk won't shout hallelujah.
Amen.
Dead folk won't clap their hands.
Yes,
dead folk won't raise their hand. Dead folk won't shout, thank you, Jesus. Dead folk don't pray. Dead folk don't respond to the word of God. I wonder this, what am I preaching to some live folk or some dead folk in the house of God?
Man.
Dead folk won't give him glory. Y'all ought to say amen.
Man.
The day that you perceive in your mind that you know more than me, you will surely die. And no matter how much we preach, no matter how much we shout, no matter how much we stomp, dead folk won't hear you.
Amen.
Go back to the grave and say, Mama, get up out the grave, she won't move. Mm-hmm. The only time she's going to move is when she can hear God say to the dead, rise. Mm-hmm. And all the dead shall rise up again.
Man.
But when we look at this great text, we find that sin is not something that happens once and stopped and you're able to repent of. We'll find that sin, according to Paul, is a living spirit. Sin is a moving entity. It is described in many ways in the book of Ephesians. I believe it's chapter 6. He describes sin having the heirs of this world and principalities and rulers of darkness. Sin does not stop just because in that moment you say, I shouldn't be doing this. But when you sin, you actually start the motions of sin. And the motions of sin, you may have stopped doing what you were doing, but sin keep right on moving. The day you lost your virginity, sin went through with you. You ought to say amen.
Amen.
You might have stopped for the next time. But sin said, I'm not finished with you yet, because the rulers and the principalities of darkness said, you had no business in act. The day you start, I'm going to make sure you don't never stop again.
Uh-huh.
Y'all look at me funny. Back to the Bible. Back to the Bible. I go, look at me. Romans chapter 2, verse number 14. Bible says, because we can't blame it all on the law, that when we were Gentiles, they did the things that were not in the law. Do by nature the things contained in the law. They became a law unto themselves. But what do you mean, preacher? That whenever sin begins, it begins a process that does not stop, because it is the law to kill and destroy that which dare touch or tamper with it. For the Bible says in Romans 7 and 5, for when we were in the flesh, the motions of sin, which were by law, did work in our members. Hold on a minute. When we were in the flesh, as long, that's what Paul said in Romans 7, going on down, he said that whatever good is, evil is where, always around. Sin did not die at the cross. Sin did not stop by the remissions of sin. Sin is still housing your members. Sin is alive and well. Sin will activate itself. Sin will move when it gets ready.
Amen.
Yes, sir. You can't do nothing with sin. When sin get a hold of you, sin will grab you and twist you. Paul said, the thing that I would do, I don't do. And the thing that I hate, I find myself doing. I find that sin is always around. Sin kept him in a situation that his very filthy rags. Sin did not die by God's forgiveness, but sin is still alive and well. And the only thing that can help us with sin is Jesus.
Amen.
It's the only thing that helps us with sin. You sin if you want to. It's much like the person who once used drug and alcohol. He may have stopped for 15 years, but the canals in his mind, you know those little wrinkle parts you see in the brain? The little wrinkle part, those are canals where dopamine once went through, serotonin levels shot up through the roof. That stuff is just running through there, and it may be a dry palate right now. But boy, let me tell you something, sin is not through with you yet. You can be walking by somewhere and smell some alcohol, and all of a sudden you're... is that hypnotic? I know hypnotic when I smell hypnotic. Now that's Hennessy right there. That's Hennessy. That's it. Because the sin, the action of sin, can be corralled, can be put in remission by God. But the fact that you sin and your perception of sin will always be with you. And you'll find yourself, you're not careful, trying to take on the devil by yourself, and you'll get yourself beat up. You'll get yourself beat up. You, let me tell you right now, if you could have saved yourself, God would not have to come, would not have to come to fulfill the law, he would not have to come to deliver us in the first place. Amen. You can't fix yourself, you can't rise above. You need Jesus. Without Jesus, everything is lost.
Man.
Are y'all with me? Are y'all with me? I want you to stop saying it, but when I get myself, well, you ain't never going to get yourself right. Because you can't control this monster. Once you told your first lie and got away, well, you've been lying ever since. Y'all understand me? You know, you saw you could fool somebody with a good lie, you became an expert liar. You started out as just a lie 101. Mm-hmm. Then you moved up the line of sociopathic lie. Then you became a pathological lie. Then you just became just an unrealistic lie, just lying for the fun of it. Then you became a greedy lie because you found that lying worked for you. And whenever you get in trouble, you might have told a lie in 10 years, you revert back to what you always
done.
Amen. I'm get through this. Let me start getting around here. So sin, therefore, write these down. Sin, therefore, has motion. Sin, the Bible says, revived itself. It came alive. That's active. That's an active part. Sin, therefore, in Romans 5 and verse 12, the Bible says sin entered into the world. How did sin enter into the world? Sin entered into the world through the fall of man. And then what happened? Sin, therefore, has a paycheck. Romans 3, verse 23, the wages of sin is what?
Death.
And then, so sin enters into the world. It brings about death. What type of death? A death that separates one from God. When you try to preach to somebody and you try to tell them about the Church of Christ, they're not going to hear you if they're dead. Mm-hmm. Because their ears or have been in tune to listen to sin. They can hear the devil. But only live folk, ye are alive this song. Live folk hear Jesus.
Amen.
Dead folk hear the devil. As soon as you say there's one Lord, one faith,
amen,
one baptism, amen, one hope, that devil, well, you say, I still got my church.
Uh-huh.
God says, upon this rock I will build my church.
Amen.
But a dead person can't hear that. And the reason they're dead is because they're dead in false doctrine.
Well.
And as hard as you preach, as much as you preach, because they're dead, they only hear what they want to hear.
Amen.
Well.
He became dead. What did he came to? I became dead to the word of God. Get from 1 Timothy chapter 4. And first, y'all look at me like I'm lying. I know I'm not lying. 1 Timothy chapter 4, I'm trying to tell you something. The folk, when folk are dead, they can't hear the word of God. Get from me. Somebody get from 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse number 4. Because there's a reason you can't hear the church. There's a reason that you are bold enough and arrogant enough. It's because your own perception that Eve had in the garden looked at what God said and said, I shall not surely die. And God said, you shall surely die. And every time you turn around and the law condemns and says you can't do something, you turn around and say, I think it is good for eating. I think that the tree is good for eating. And sin is at work because sin is at motion. And when sin is at motion, sin will stop you from talking to God. Sin will stop you from having a relationship with God. Sin found motion in Romans 5, 12. Sin pays in Romans 3. Verse number 23, sin separates Isaiah 59, 1 through 2. Sin separates men from God. Sin has a job. Sin didn't die. Bible says in, which one I call for first? 1 Timothy 4, verse 1, the Bible says what?
Now the Spirit speaks expressly.
That in the latter time.
Some shall depart from the
tree. I can go to the tree if I want to go to the tree.
Some shall depart from the
tree. I can go to wherever church I want to go to.
Some shall depart
from the tree. You don't tell me. You just narrow-minded. Any church is a large church. I don't think God. Can you hear Eve talking to the devil right now? He know we ain't. He just don't want you to eat it. And the Bible said when she came to her own mind, and her perception after the seed had been planted, she said, that tree looked good. That church looked just like a church to me. What did God say? Hold on a minute. That church looked just like you. They got a Bible in that church. They got a preacher in that church. They got everything. What you mean there's not but one church? Eve, will you listen? God said, there's one tree. You can't mess with it. But the Bible said when she perceived that the tree was good, when they looked and saw that the other church was good, they ate of the tree.
Well,
it was pleasant to the eye. Instrument of music and commune whatever you want to it, preach whatever you want to it, lie on God. And God said this to me, and God said that to me, and convince yourself of a lie.
Reach.
Sin is at Reach. Work in your heart, and it's making yes, rebel. Sir. Against the very word of God.
Man.
There's a reason you can't hear that. That's why when you're preaching, there's a preaching, people start frying up. Because when dead folk hear you preaching, talking about the sun gonna come up, they know they gotta get in before the sun get up, because they're gonna blow up in the movie. Every time the sun, they had to run in the darkness. Y'all didn't watch the movie. So it was a trip. They couldn't stay out in the sunlight. Watch this, every time you preach to church, dead folk don't hear nothing about no church. Dead folk only hear the devil. And the reason why I say it, because Jesus said, the only people hear him.
It's his. Man.
In John 10, verse 3, he said, my sheep
hear my voice. Man.
I know them.
And they know me.
And they know me.
Preach it.
And whenever somebody said the Lord ain't one church, if you any kind of sheep of God, you may not understand it all, but your ears ought to stick up, because you know there's 700 churches, and you're concerned as the white man just said that ain't one church.
Well.
And some of you ought to start moving closer. Let me hear this, man. But if you dead, you just keep right on walking. You ain't talking to me. I know what I know. Eve, sit down and listen to Eve. He said, I was alive once. Law came. Sin was identified to me.
Mm-hmm.
Sin revived and I died.
Man.
Sin and you can't live together. Mm-hmm. Sin has a job to do. Sin puts itself in motion, and sin has a message. And that message is God is a liar and I'm the truth.
Well.
And if you in any other church but the Lord's church, you believe that message. And so the Bible says, now the Spirit speaketh expressively. What is the Spirit doing? The Spirit is speaking distinctly. Mm-hmm. That in the latter times,
some shall depart from the faith. Giving heed,
listening to seducing spirits and doctrines of the devil. But watch this. They can hear the doctrine of the devil. They can hear this church and that church and do what you want to, and I don't feel it, I don't think it. They can hear all that stuff. But he said, give me some two spirits out of the devil, but why can't they hear the Lord talking? Mm-hmm. Having their what?
Speaking lies
and hypocrisy.
Having their conscience.
Their heart seared. It's been seared.
Well,
they've been seared to the word of God.
Man.
Talking to dead folk, you say, you know, we ought to, do the Bible say, don't forsake the assembly of yourself, because dead folk ain't coming to you. They dead. And if you make a dead person talk, they change something you don't want to hear. I'm busy. I got something to do. Did you hear Hebrews 10:25? Dead folk gonna start arguing with you then. You can't, you ain't nobody gonna go to hell for me. Nobody have no fight. All I'm saying to you is that we ought to meet when it's time to meet and study God's word. Do you hear Jesus in that?
Man.
Is there anything to fight about in that?
No, sir.
But some reason you're hearing something else, because you're not listening to me. You listen to the devil's influence that's inside of you, that's making motions and delivering another message.
Man.
Who are you to tell me what I'm gonna do?
Well, preach it.
Amen. 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 Which is one of us? Dracula. God is saying through his word, he said that there's some folk who are so dead, they're conscious of sin with a hot iron. And so they'll just keep doing what they've been doing because they're dead. They're alive, but they're dead. And they're just walking like this, walking through life just dead, just listening to different voices. And here's the problem. When you're in a dead state with God, you never satisfy the flesh. Mm-hmm. You never, no matter what you do, you can smoke all and drink all and say something, but you'll never satisfy the flesh. Because the flesh is an entity in and of itself. It is uncurable. It is unsatisfiable. That's why God said when death comes, when the last enemy on the destroy, it's going to be death itself. Everything sinful is going to be cast in the lake of hell. Why? Because it's going to be alive when he gets here. Alive and well. He said, I'm going to throw all that stuff away because it can't come to where I am.
Man.
So you're never satisfied. That's why you hear it and you've been on the same stuff, living in your flesh, and you feel like you're dead. You're looking like you're dying. Your energy, your youth is gone. You're tired. You wore yourself out in the streets, making them cuts and turns.
Well.
Because you can't satisfy the flesh. And as smart as you are, Eve, you were wrong. You died the very moment you defied God.
Reggie.
You died to his word. Folk preach. You rolling your eyes while they preach. Dead to the word of God. Instead of hearing the word of God, you listen to the man.
Man.
Who are you? I ain't nobody. I'm a nobody. Trying to tell everybody.
About somebody. Save.
That can save everybody. Anybody.
Man.
I'm trying to tell folk that Jesus is the only answer. Paul declared that he's encased in a body of sin. Paul declares in 2 Corinthians 4 and verse number 4 that if our gospel be hid, it is hidden to those who are lost. If you can't hear that the Lord died on Calvary's cross, if you can't hear that the Lord blood paid for his church in Acts 20 and 28, if you can't hear that baptism is for the remission of sin and commanded by God, if you can't hear that God decreed how it wants to be worshipped, it may have seemed just like a little tree to Eve, but it was the biggest tree she ever ate off in her life. And the Bible says that when she ate off of the tree in Romans 5 and 12, that death entered through man and death entered into the world through man. Am I right about it? And because death entered into the world, death is going to be here as the last enemy between man and God. And so God says, when I get you up to heaven, those of you that can still hear me, I'm going to take death, throw death in the fiery grave, that it'll never ever be there again. Don't you want to live this morning? I'm just talking to 10 folk that can actually hear me. You've been living a dead life for a long time. You're just like those folk in Timothy, where the Bible says that they were twice dead. They died in this world, but you have to die in the world to come. If you can still hear me, I'm trying to tell you that God is your only answer. God is the only answer. Listen to what God does.